Hello students, so today we are going to start this lecture on machine learning. So in this lecture we will discuss about machine learning and different techniques of machine learning with their suitable examples. So this is an introductory kind of lecture, so let's start. So first of all, what is machine learning? So before understanding the concept of machine learning, let me ask you, what is learning? A human learning. So what is human learning? A learning is making successful changes in our minds. So whatever we can learn, it should be observed through our mind so that we can take the decisions, right? Learning denotes changes in a system that enables a system to do the same task more efficiently the next time. For example, if you are going to market for the first time, so you don't know the way. From which way you are going to the market, but after going the market multiple times, you are going to know that this is the best suitable way to reach the market in the less efficient time, more efficient time, right? So this is how you make the decisions, and how you are going to make the decisions through learning, and how you learn by attempting the given options, right? So what are algorithms? So algorithms or techniques that enable computer, or you can say machine, to learn from data. So what is machine learning? Machine learning is nothing but an algorithm, or you can say a technique that enable computer. So what is computer? Computer is a machine. So a technique which enable a machine to learn from the data. So what is data? Data is anything. Whatever you are saying, whatever you are collecting is the data. For example, you went for a picnic and you click some pictures. So the pictures are data. You posted on the social network site. So on the social network site, it is data. So you are creating the data, and after creating the data, you are uploading to some internet websites, right? So you are generating the data. Now, how the learning model works in machine learning? So there are two things that you have to keep in mind while studying about the machine learning. You should know what is training and what is testing. So there are two things. First is training. Training means you are training the model. You are training a system or a machine, and after training the machine, you got a trained machine, and this trained machine will be tested in the second phase. So in this example, in this figure, you can see the input samples are given to the training system. The training system will make a learning model, and it is an iterative process. Initially, you find 10 ways to go to market. After that, you have identified that only 5 is good ways to reach to the market. And after this iterative process, you have identified this is the most optimal way to reach the market. Now you will apply this learned model to test some of the other routes, right? For example, now this learned model will be given to your friend. You will give it to your friend that by using this model you can reach to the market. Now there are various parts or types of machine learning. So this is 3 types of machine learning. The first one is supervised learning, the second one is unsupervised learning, and third one is reinforcement learning. So let's understand by observing this figure on the extreme left right hand side that in supervised learning there are 2 parts. The one is classification and the second one is regression, and after that each one method is having their own techniques. Right, in the classification you are having the image classification, where you classify that these are the images of a forest, these are the images of a road, or these are the images of the humans, right? So you are classifying the images. Second, you can identify the fraud detection with the help of some machine learning algorithm. In the classification, you can identify whether the next person is going to do some fraud or not. In the same manner, if you see in the regression, regression is nothing but it shows some dependency between two variables. The one variable is dependent on another. So both are somehow similar, the classification regression, but regression deals only with the variable kind of problems. Just like weather forecasting. So you are going to forecast or predict the weather tomorrow based on the given last 10 days weather report. Fine. So this is the regression. Now coming to the unsupervised learning. In unsupervised learning, there are two parts. The first one is clustering and second is dimensionality reduction. So in the clustering, you cluster the data points or the users. You just make the group of the similar kind of points. In the dimensionality reduction, you reduce the dimension or you reduce the size or the features of the given problem. Right, it is something like the compression. You are just compressing such that the information can be identified in a much easier way. Right, and the third part is reinforcement learning. Reinforcement learning is generally used in the robotics design or the artificial intelligence game design or some learning tasks. Just like robot, you are making some robot and giving him some tasks to perform, right? We'll see each of them in the next slide in more detail. So there are three different kind of problems in machine learning. So the first we have seen the supervised learning. So in the supervised learning, here you can see there are some stars in the green, some circles in the red, and some plus signs in the blue, right? So how you are going to segregate all this data? This is the task of machine learning. So all this data is given to machine learning. Now machine learning algorithm or the supervised learning will identify, okay, this is the star, it will goes to this category, this is the circle, it will goes to this category, and this is the plus, it will goes to this category. So this is a segregation kind of data based on some labels. So what are those labels over here? Labels are the shape of the given object. So what is the shape of the given object? Based on that, it will goes to that particular category or the class. So if the shape of the given object or the upcoming object is a star, it will goes to star class. If the shape of the upcoming data point is circle, it will goes to the circle class, right? We'll see the supervised learning with the example. Now coming to the unsupervised learning. So unlike the supervised learning, the unsupervised learning, there is no label. You don't know the shape of the data or the label of the data. So what is the label of the data? You don't know. So how you are going to make the group of the available data points? That's a big task. So generally what happens, the similar kind of data points remains in the same range. For example, in the classroom, if you see the most similar friend group will sit together, right? So we can identify that these are the most like-minded user to each other. Fine. So on the basis of some distance function, the unsupervised learning identify that this particular data point is belongs to this particular group, right? Now the third type of problem can be a semi-supervised learning, where there are some supervised and unsupervised data points are there, from where we have some labels of the data points and there is no label to some data points. We can say this is the mix of the supervised and unsupervised learning algorithm. Fine. The most beautiful example of classification is your Gmail box. Here your Gmail in the backend will identify whether the incoming email is a primary email or a social email or a promotion or some updates, or is it a spam email, right? So the category or the class identification through the label of upcoming email is known as the classification. You are just making the class of the incoming email. So whether it goes to primary and spam is depend upon the methodology that is used to identify that particular email, right? Now there are two parts in the training and testing in this supervised learning. The first part is training. Training means you are having the entire data set. Now this entire data set will be broken into two parts. The first one is training set and second one is the testing set. In the training set, there are some unobserved data. You don't know what is the class of this particular. Sorry, this is the observed. You know that it is a plus class, or is it is a circle class. You know the label of the data. So you will make the training model with this, with the help of this training set. Generally, the entire data set is divided into the 66-34% ratio. The 66% of the entire data is used to build training set and 34 is used to make this testing set, right? So in the training set, the data is used to make the model, and in the testing set, the data is used to test the incoming new data point, right? So what are unobserved here? We don't know what is the label of this incoming input data, right? Now how we are going to segregate this particular data set? There is no linear separation of this particular data set. Draw this line? No, there are some points, points are in the wrong class, right? Two circles are in the star class and three star in the circle class. Now you have the final decision boundary. So this is the decision boundary, how you are going to divide the data in such a way that the one class is having the particular label data and the other class is having the particular type of data. Face recognition is the most important or well-known example of the supervised learning, where you are having the different sides and different points of FAS, right? So there are four positional picture of a single person. Now you will give this four set of test image. Now your task is to identify whether which person is in this training set, right? So this is how the face recognition works. Now the second part is unsupervised learning. Unsupervised learning is having the data which are not having the label. As we have discussed in the last slide, there is no label. We just have to make the group of the incoming or the make the group of the given data set. There are two things that we have to keep remember. First, in the class, the distance between all the data objects should be less. So the intra-cluster distance should be less and the inter-cluster distance should be high. So now look at the technique which is a k-means algorithm which comes under the unsupervised learning algorithm, right? So in the k-means algorithm, what is happening? We have to make k number of groups of the given data set. So you have to identify that, okay, just give me 100 points and I will make the groups of the similar data objects, right? So you don't know the number of groups because you don't know the label of the incoming object. So deciding the value of k is the crucial task. So let's suppose I decide the k is equals to 3. It means I will make 3 groups of the all data points. Now first you have to identify the centroid. Centroid is the mean of the all data points, right? Centroid is the, you can say, the monitor of the class. Centroid will decide whether a next data point is similar or will belongs to his class or some other class, right? Now you will use some distance function in order to identify whether a data point belongs to X class, X group or Y group. Then after identifying the distance, you just group it, right? And you keep iterating all these things till there is no changes in the group formation. So this is the stopping criteria. Just look at this particular figure. Here you can observe that there may be different five data points, five groups, right? There are five groups, but as a human we can identify, but how machine is going to identify, it depends upon the technique that you are going to use. So in the k-means algorithm, first there are some random. Here you can see there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have taken 5 random points. Now iterate it such that it goes to some group or some dense position. How this initial centroid is moving to this position based on this distance, right? So see, moving, like why it is moving, because whenever a new data point is assigned to this centroid, the similarity is computed and it will assign to this centroid. And after assigning that particular centroid into this particular centroid, then the mean is calculated, and after taking the mean, the centroid will be changed until reach to some midpoints. So here this is the final output of the k-means algorithm. This is the graphical representation. If you go through the k-means algorithms thoroughly, you will identify that what we are doing, what is the mean over here and how the similarity is computing. We will have a separate lecture for the k-means algorithm in the next class. Now the third and last part is the reinforcement learning. As I said earlier, reinforcement learning is used for the game playing, is used in the robotics, is used in the artificial intelligence game, right? So the total phenomena of reinforcement learning is based upon the reward and penalty mechanism. Just understand this. If your robot do some task correctly, the robot will be rewarded. If your robot do some task correctly, the robot will be rewarded. Otherwise, the robot will have a penalty. So after receiving the penalty, the robot will rectify its problem, and after that it will again do the given task. So if the task is performed correctly, then the robot will be rewarded, right? So what is the task? Build a system with maximum reward. We just want to make a robot which can have maximum reward. So if a robot is having the maximum reward, we can say that this robot is the best robot, right? So here in this picture you can see, so there is a rat and the task is to find out this piece of bread, and if the robot find in the correct manner, then it will eat the piece of bread. Otherwise, the piece of bread will be taken, right? What are the applications? The game playing, a robot in a match, multiple agents, right? So this is used mainly for the robotics and artificial intelligence game playing. Okay, thank you. So we have seen the three different types of machine learning. One is supervised learning, where there is label. Second one is the unsupervised learning, where we do grouping without having the labels. And third one is the reinforcement learning, which is mainly used for the robotics kind of things. So if you have any query, you can send me an email. Thank you.